Well, as you just heard, temperatures supposed to drop below freezing tonight. So, who wants to go camping?
Not me.
All right.
But a group of dedicated history buffs are braving the elements right in front of the Alamo tonight. Ooh. And JT Street is with them.
Oh, look at that.
For now, he is.
Yeah.
JT.
Deep in the heart of Texas.
Every time. Hey, guys. I'm out here on Alamo Plaza with the San Antonio Living History Association. We've got campfires, we've got blankets, we've got some tunes. Really the best the 1830s can offer. Now, if you're like me and you're wondering why the heck somebody would want to do this, we found out earlier today. With ice-cold determination and fingers, Grant Maloney sets up camp for his fellow Texians.
We didn't pick the day, history did. On this day, back in 1835, the Texians were getting ready to lay siege to San Antonio de Bejar.
An event which Grant and his group planned to reenact with historic accuracy, including the weather.
The Mexican garrison didn't expect the Texians would attack because it was so cold and so miserable.
A sentiment shared by modern-day spectators.
It's already cold right now, so I don't even know how they're going to last the night. I mean, I don't know.
We're camping in period-correct canvas tents, and we have a fire out here and a wooden bucket for water.
As enticing as that sounds, Grant and his crew have also had to deal with another historically accurate obstacle: desertion.
We were going to have several more people camping out with us here tonight, but a lot of them chickened out and they're staying in hotels tonight.
So that's what happens to the deserters of the Living History Association.
Right, they stay in a hotel.
But for diehard history buffs like Grant, the cold is an opportunity to understand history in finger-numbing fashion.
Half of the reason you get into reenacting is you read about these heroes of old, and you think, how did they live that way? What did they do? How did they stand a 30-degree night? This is exactly the way it was. So back in 1835, so.
Does that make you happy?
It makes me happy. My wife, who's spending the night with me out here tonight, that does not make her happy.
Now, tomorrow morning, the reenactors will thaw out, pack up, and head down to historic La Vieta, where they'll be reenacting the Battle of Bejar two times at 10 a.m. and 2 a.m. If you'd like to fire up some stories for Streets Corner, you can follow me on Twitter at Streets Corner or like us on Facebook.com/Streets Corner. Live from deep in the heart of La Vieta, JT Street, Fox News at 9. Everybody, one more time. Deep in the heart of Texas.